Good evening to all. I am Shanti, working as an assistant professor in Sri Ishwar College of Engineering. Now we are going to discuss about various issues in the design of code generator in the compiler design subject. We already know the basis of compiler. Pushing out over the code generator in the compiler model is the last phase of the compiler. We have front end. It comprises the lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer, and intermediate code generator. It will produce the output as the intermediate code that is given as input to your compiler. It is a code optimizer. It will generate the intermediate code, that is optimized intermediate code, as the output that is given to the code generator. Finally, the code generator generates the target assembly language program. You already know the symbol table is connected with all the phases of the compiler. See, you need some requirements to produce the good optimized code, good target code. Your output code must be correct, then must be in high quality, and also it should run efficiently, and it is also good. See, now we are having the 6 issues in the design of code generator. One is input to the code generator, target programs, memory management, instruction selection, register allocation, choice of evaluation order. Now we will see the input to the code generator. See, we already know in the phases of compiler, the output of the code optimizer is the optimized 3-address statement that is given as input to your code generator. So the input to the code generator is the intermediate representation, that is 3-address format. We can have 3 representation of the 3-address code. Intermediate representation, one is linearized representation. It means it is represented in the form of postfix. 3-address statements also, that is quadruples. We already have studied in 3-address statements that should be represented in quadruples, triples, and indirect triples. And here, 3-address representation we can look as the quadruples. Next, virtual machine representation. It deals about the stack machine code. In the topic of stack allocation and static allocation, we have studied about the how to generate the stack machine code. Third one is graphical representation. It is given by the syntax trees or DATs. So you already know the symbol table is connected with all the phases of the compiler. So the symbol table is used to determine the runtime addresses of the data objects. We can have the 3-address statements. 3-address statements have the many operands and variables. Variables is also called as operands. The values of the names appearing in the intermediate language is always represented by the bits, integers, reals, and pointers. We already know we are having the lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, and semantic analyzer. These 3 phases are called analysis phase. The semantic analyzer will then be type checking operation. That is, if we have any errors in the source program, that should be corrected by your semantic analyzer. There you are checking the all the types, and if all the types are same type, then that will be given as input to your intermediate code generator that generate the intermediate 3-address codes. Next, when you are giving the input to the code generator, your input must be in free of errors. Next, we are having the target programs. So we can have the 3 representative, 3 forms of the outputs. One is absolute machine language. The second one is relocatable machine language. Third one is assembly level language. See, what is absolute machine language? It is in the form of zeros and ones. Directly it is placed on the fixed memory location and immediately executed because it is in the form of zeros and ones. Next, we are having relocatable machine language. What is relocatable? We can change the address of the statements. That is, whenever we are having the changing of the addresses, we can have the different types of subprograms. We can compile all the subprograms separately. Then we need the linter that should link all the subprogram files, compile the subprogram files. So it is very expensive because you need a linter and loader to perform all the operations. Hence, we can have the assembly language. It can generate the symbolic instructions and use the macro facilities of the assembler to help the generate the code. It is very easier. We already know the output of the target program. Compiler is target program, that is in the form of assembly level language. Next, memory management. How memory is managed during the design of the code generator? The input to the code generator is the three address format. So whenever that reads the three address statements, all the informations are updated in your symbol table. Symbol table contains the variable names, that is identifiers, and also the relative address. See, you already have studied about the declarations. Whenever you declare the variable, that should be updated in your symbol table. That is, entries are created in the symbol table. We already know what is static allocation and stack allocation. Static allocation, your memory address will not be changed. That is statically allocated. But in case of stack allocation, we can do some alterations. So whenever we are performing the memory management, our input is the three address statement. The labels of the three address statement should be converted into addresses. Here, three address code contains the represented by the quadruples. That is, each address is tracked by a quadruple arrays. Here we are having the concept called backpatching. That is, whenever you are having the statement go to I, here I value is less than the J value. So your quadruple number is the first machine instruction. So you have to apply the backward jump. That is, that will move back and start their execution. Suppose if I value is greater than the J value, then you have to perform the forward jump. Because later the quadruple array number is allocated. See, instruction selection. How we are going to select the instructions during the code generation? See, uniformity and completeness of the instruction set is very, very important. Whenever you are selecting the instruction, that should provide the maximized speed. That is, that should run fast, that should perform fast. See, here you can see the example. X is equal to Y plus Z. It is a three address statement. This should be converted into assembly level language. That is, here we used three instructions, move, add, and move. These are all called symbolic instructions. See, move. Here you are adding Y plus Z, that result is thrown into the X. So you have to move the Y value into the register R0. Then you have to add the value Z with the R0. Then the result is stored in your R0. So final result is actually evaluated result is assigned to X. So you have to move the result of the register R0 into the X. So here we are having three instructions to evaluate these three other statements. Next, we are having one more examples. That is A equal to B plus C, D equal to A plus C. So now this is called three other statements. Now you are going to generate the assembly instructions for this. First, you have to move the value B to the register R0. Then that will be added with the register C. So the final result is moved into the A because B plus C is assigned to A. Next, this A is used in next three of the statement, that is B equal to A plus C. So you have to move that register value A into the value of A into the R0. Next, you have to add E with the result of the R0. Then that will be moved. The R0, you are having the results. That results is moved into the variable D. Suppose you assume here A is not used in further instructions, further statement, that variable is called dead variable. That is, it is not alive. But in this case, A is used in the second three address statement. So it is a live variable. So whenever it is a live variable, you have to move that value into the register R0. Suppose if it is a dead variable, these two instructions will be redundant code. So similarly, you can have one more three other statements, A equal to A plus 1. Here you are incrementing the A value by 1. For this, you are going to write the machine level instructions, that is assembly level language instructions. Here you are using the move and add instructions. Initially move the value of A into the register R0. Then that one value 1 will be added into the register R0. Finally the result will be moved into the variable A. So instead of that you can select the one more instruction that is called INC, that is increment A. Here you have to give them 3 instructions to execute A equal to A plus 1. Instead of that it will have only one instruction, that is INC, that will increment the A value by 1. So in this way you have to select the instruction that should be an efficient one, that is that will produce the faster running time. You are reducing the number of instructions, that is you are minimizing the number of instructions. In this way the faster execution will be provided. It's register allocation. How the register will be allocated during the generation of the target code. Generally, always whenever you are using the registers, the task of the register is no task will be provided for storing the instructions in the registers. So instructions involving register operands are shorter and faster than the operands in the memory. So better you can use the registers for utilization of the for performing the calculations. So whenever you are taking the memory, that will incur more tasks. So task 3 is that is register will provide no task. So better always try to utilize registers, that will provide the more efficiency. Next, register allocation. So this will be divided into 2 parts. One is register allocation, another one is register assignment. Now during the register allocation, you can select the set of variables that will reside in the registers at a point in the program. During the subsequent register assignment phase, you pick a specific register that a variable will reside in. Optimal assignment of register is too difficult, so it is comes under the NP-complete problem. Register allocation always done by register first. You are having the 2 or even and odd numbered registers first are represented by even and odd number. It may be required for some instructions. You can have the instruction MXY, that is multiply X and Y. Here X is called the multiplicand, Y is called the multiplier. So you assume X is in odd register, Y is in another single register. When you are multiplying X and Y, the result is in pair of registers. That is, it will contact that will take both even and odd, that is register pair. Next, you can have the division, that is X and Y. Division of X by Y. Here, X is called dividend, Y is called divisor. You assume X is stored in the even register, Y is in the single register. And then after performing the division operation, result will be stored in the even register. The result, that is remainder, will be stored in the even register. Quotient will be stored in the odd register. So sometimes we are having the registers pass for allocating the registers during the creation of the target code. Last issue is choice of evaluation order. So whenever we are performing the evaluation, the order of evaluation is very, very important because it will affect the efficiency of your target code. But maximum try to use only fewer registers to generate the target code. If you are using the more registers, that will accommodate more processing. So better you try to use the registers, try to reuse the registers. So choosing order is also an NP-complete problem. Thank you.